Okay, world, so we're in the middle of 2021, and here in the United States, the pandemic is getting to the point where people are going to be going back to work and things are going to start happening, which means that, well, more PCs will probably be purchased. Now, a question on probably every person's mind who hasn't bought a computer is, who do I choose, AMD or Intel? I mean, that's a great question, right? Let's talk tech. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to the Your CD Key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. Okay, so AMD or Intel in 2021. Now, before I jump into the video, I ask courtesy of you folks, if you could please like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you like what you see. So let's move forward. So for many, many years, Intel pretty much was the leader in the desktop CPU market for gaming. It's just a fact. There have been a few times where AMD's been ahead, but you know, that was, you know, more of something different than the rule. You know what I mean? That wasn't the rule, that was the difference than the rule. You know what I'm saying? But now that we're in the current generations of things, things have changed a lot. Now, Intel for years pretty much did not do any real innovation with their CPU technology. It was pretty much a bump, a skip, a bump, a skip. Same x86 technology has been going on for like literally like almost seems like almost 30 years. And until recently, when AMD has really picked up the ball with Ryzen and RDNA and all this stuff, did Intel even seem to really take notice that, you know, there was competition, but all of a sudden it's like, oh my God, there's competition. Now, if you're just talking about features and specs and stuff like that, it's really hard to pinpoint who is an exactly clear leader right now as far as the technologies go. Now, AMD has caught up really, really far with their Ryzen stuff. And the Intel stuff, even though, you know, in some cases, some people might say, oh, you know, okay, here and there, it's still doing a little bit better. I don't know. For me, it really kind of comes down to a couple of things these days. And before, when I first started out being a journalist and talking about tech, I would have always just solely said, okay, you know what, this particular company right here has the better product, so maybe I might, you know, do that. But in the modern day market, where AMD just has so much going for them all around, and Intel, even though they've got good motherboards and they've got good CPUs, it's hard for me to really go out and say to somebody, hey, you know what, you should buy Intel, because honestly, I'm not giving my money to Intel anymore. I stopped, and I'm gonna tell you why. It's because Intel sat on their laurels so bad that probably the most ingenious guy they ever had at their company, Francois Pernoux, I hope I'm saying his name right. Francois was the genius, you know, CPU designer guy. He was the man. Sometimes he can get a bit arrogant, but I still love the guy, and I think there's been a misunderstanding between us. So if you talk to him, you might think we're arguing, but we're not. But losing him was a big sign to me about how things are going at Intel. When you have somebody who basically, who lived, died, and breathed Intel, and he left the company because they're just stagnant, what does that tell you? That means like he's trying to say, hey, I'd like to make some new CPUs, let's do some new technologies, but you got the company saying, oh no, well why should we? I mean, everything we're doing is still selling. That to me is a big deal. Plus the very fact that over the years, Intel has been caught doing some really, really shady shite on the side market stuff. You know, trying to get it so that vendors only carried their stuff, totally ousting AMD. You know, it's just not enough to say at this point, even if Intel did have a product that was a little bit better, and I'd be really hard pressed to say it right at this point in time that Intel really has anything that's totally better than AMD. AMD has caught up so much in the market with their new Ryzen CPUs that it's just insane. And the reason why I would suggest for you to give your money to AMD over Intel is for this fact and this fact alone. Intel did really nothing to earn your money over the last 20 years, other than the fact that they held patents and all kinds of crazy stuff, kept AMD in court, always, you know, making them so that they had to be the underdog because they had to fight all these battles in order to do it. And then all of a sudden, as things changed, well, AMD is now right neck and neck with them, and they didn't have to play as much dirty pool really to get there. So AMD is a company that we see on the innovation technological edge. AMD is really trying to change the market and bring great CPUs to the market. Intel is only going to be changing their game now that they're getting their ass kicked in the market. I mean, it's just the fact. If Intel still had their way, they'd be blocking AMD and they'd still be giving us these subpar bumps in our CPUs. Honestly, when AMD had the bulldozer era, that was kind of a bad time for them. Those CPUs were really rotten. I still tried to support them by building systems, even though people beat me up. They were like, what the heck, are you paid by AMD? It's like, no, I was trying to keep them alive. You know, you've always got to have an underdog. When Intel was at the top, you had to have somebody at the bottom. I mean, that's just how it is, right? Two guys in a wrestling match, two guys in a fight, two guys in a kung fu fight, one guy walks out the victor. I mean, you know, one guy's the loser. May not be a loser, but that person goes on to fight another day, and it's been the same thing with these CPU, you know, wars for years. AMD might get licked, have to, you know, sign all these, you know, crazy tax documents over the years of losing money, but they've been trying to innovate. And really, as soon as the gates of Sharam were open, AMD has been doing nothing but making leaps and bounds in their technology. Every generation you can see that's coming out is better technology. Where Intel now is only really going, okay, well, I guess we'll change some stuff. So here's my take. Like I said, back when I first became a journalist, I would have strictly went out and talked about the parts, and in my mind, it would have been all about just performance and nothing else. But when we see a playing field that at this point I feel is, you know, it's getting really, really even. I know there's going to be some people out there still saying, you know, oh, Intel does better here. But, you know, AMD has come so far and is still coming so far that it's even going to be hard pressed for them to keep, you know, trouting the Intel flag, you know, if they don't innovate. I mean, so if anybody at Intel is watching this video, I hope you guys are going to wake the fuck up and start doing some stuff and making some serious changes. You've got the money to do it. And, you know, I'll make another one of these videos in a couple of years and we'll see how things are going. But, you know, for the rest of 2021 and 2022, I would honestly say support AMD just strictly for the fact that you have a company that wants to innovate, that wants to bring better stuff to the market. I think that's more important than just somebody who's been sitting on their laurels for years and years and years. And even though in some little area or two, you know, maybe they might be doing a little better, most people out there these days are gamers. And AMD has great stuff for gaming. It's totally compatible. It's totally compatible with Intel. No, I'm just kidding. They're not compatible. It's totally competing with Intel. And that says a lot to me. I mean, a few years ago, I would have been the total opposite and said, no way, you know, you need to buy Intel. AMD CPUs, they suck. I didn't buy any AMD CPUs, except for the Bulldozer. I bought it because everybody was beating up so bad. I thought, wow, man, this company really needs a break. Like, seriously, I'm not even joking. I was like, wow, these guys need some help. So I better, you know, try to help them as much as I can because they're getting the crap kicked out of them in the arena this time. So I've tried to support AMD as best as possible, being the underdog, but I don't really feel that right now they're totally the underdog. They are the underdog, but they're an underdog who's won, like, you know, what? What, let's be fair, 9 out of the 12 fights? You guys can give me some things down below in your comments, tell me what you guys think, you know? They've won like 9 out of 12 spots. They're competing in every market that there is. Epic is in the server market. They have all kinds of stuff in the workstation market. Ryzen is kicking butt in the gaming and desktop arena. There's all kinds of good stuff there. Intel has some products, but they're still ho-hum compared to what they should be on the market. So I'm Elric. Thanks for watching this video. I much appreciate it. You guys saw that little ad placement in the beginning of the video with the Windows 10 keys and that stuff. Hundreds of people have bought those that I know personally. There's been hundreds of comments throughout the videos of people have bought them. There's never been a problem. All the codes are guaranteed. It's a great way to help keep my site around. Also, if you want to keep the site around, don't pay any money. I have a link down below for Amazon Prime. Try my link. Use it to try Amazon Prime for 30 days. They give me financial credit. It helps keep the site around. And if you don't need a Windows key, hey, for a single dollar, you can support me on Patreon. So that's my take, folks. In 2021, when it comes to a battle between AMD and Intel, I say choose AMD because I think they're the people that are fighting for you more than Intel. Enough said. Peace out.